What's up, everybody? It's your boy Meep here. For breakfast, I had a bagel. For lunch, I had some pizza, some leftover pizza because we had pizza for dinner yesterday. And for dinner, I'm not too sure what we're gonna have, but we're gonna have something for sure. I'm just hanging out today. I'm going to be studying. Yesterday, I watched the Two Clicks Philip video on JPEG XL. Which is really interesting. I've heard Brody Robertson talk about JPEG XL and like some other stuff. And I never really knew what it was. I knew it was like a new image format that like is good, but I never really looked into it until Two Clicks Philip's JPEG XL video. And I actually have some interesting JPEG XL quality comparisons. Now, first, I must say, now this is one of my thumbnails from November of 2023, and I'm going to be using it as like an example. But I must say that this is at many different quality amounts, but they're all at 10 effort. The effort amount is like the amount of time it spends doing the thing. But the thing is that the longer you let it spend doing its thing, the better quality it is. So these are all at 10 effort. I bet if it was like, let me just do this, quality 1, effort 1, right? JXL test bad.jxl, right? And then I open this up. Yeah, I don't know, it doesn't look too much worse, but. But anyway, I just want to show you guys different like quality comparisons. So one really cool thing about PNG, really cool thing about JXL when compared to PNG is when the quality level is at 100, there is no visual difference in loss, except there's no difference in loss. But there is a difference in size, right? So like, if you look here, you'll notice that jxltest.png is 1.2 megabytes, or mebabytes technically, but jxltest100.jxl is about half that, a little under half the size, which is crazy, right? So yeah, you'll notice if I zoom into a specific area and I switch, this is the PNG, then this is the JXL at 100. Oh, hold on. You'll see that this is, hold on. Sure. You'll see that this is like no quality difference, and it's basically the same for like half the image size, which is great. We go to 99, and I'm pretty sure there's also no difference. Something interesting is that the difference between 100 quality and 99 quality is really high. It doesn't go back down to like being under 100 until it's at like 75, which I find really strange. Yeah, so there's no difference between that and 99, even though it's, you know, twice as big as the PNG. But yeah, it's pretty cool. Yeah, no difference between that and 99. What about near the color? Oh, maybe something. It seems like here, there's like some color, like some banding. Do you see that? This is 99, this is the original PNG. This is the JXL, this is the PNG. So there is a minor quality difference as opposed to 100, which is zero difference, right? But 99, a very, very minor difference around the colors here. Let's see if it continues on. Oh yeah, it kind of goes on throughout here. Yeah, so that's interesting. That's something to keep in mind. Also keep in mind that this thumbnail is in 4K. It's originally a 480p thumbnail, but whenever I am using my thumbnails for anything, I just upscale them to 4K because they're not meant to be. A lot of the time when I send someone a thumbnail of mine and it's in 480p, I send it and it's native resolution, it scales it up bicubically and it makes all the sharp edges and dots look like sort of circles. And it sucks because that's not how it's intended to look. So I bring it up to 4K with no interpolation, and it just looks how I want it to look. But yeah, so we're gonna go from 99 to, and it's good to keep in mind that you can't see a difference, like when it's zoomed out from 99 to 100, you can't see a difference. 96, same thing, you can't really see a difference, but I bet if we zoom in, yeah, what's the difference between 99 and 96? Is 96, 99, 96, 99. Oh, you know what? It looks like broadly among this noise in the background, there's like some, it kind of blurs itself together. Do you see that? Just a little bit. Okay. I don't know how much of this you guys see, but yeah. There's the JPEG XL, here's the PNG. You can see some very minor blurriness. What about here? Oh yeah, yeah, you can see like sort of some stuff around the dot here. Okay, let's go for 90. So how it looks at 90. Let's go for color. Oh, you can see a pretty obvious, there's like a blue and orange sort of, I accidentally did a box. There's a blue and orange sort of like ripple effect coming out of here now. Oh yeah, and whoa, and everything's super blurred around the in the noise. Do you see that? Super obvious now at 90. Yeah, huh. Really quick, let me just get the bad version in here at the very end. But yeah, at 90 it looks like we're getting some pretty obvious like blending of colors and noise in the background. And we're getting like a interesting effect here right next to the orange. And okay, let's go to 75, which is a pretty big jump. Let's see if we can see it from here really quick. 90, JXL, PNG, JXL, PNG, yeah, JXL, PNG, right? Let's go for 75. Still can't tell, really. But if we zoom in, we definitely will be able to. So this is the original PNG, and then let's go for this. Oh yeah, you can tell. It's like, there's barely any definition in the background, for sure. Do you see that? Let me go between, this is the JXL, this is the PNG at 75 quality. You could just see it gets a little blurrier. Now, this is a lot better than JPEG, I will give them that. And it's really cool that it's a lossless between PNG and JPEG at 100. And it also supports transparency and a whole bunch of other things. And I'm very strongly considering moving a lot of my screenshots to JXL instead of PNG. But yeah, I just like to, you know, kind of push compression to the limits a little bit. And just about now at JXL test 75, we're now finally at a lower, we're finally at a lower size than JXL 99, which is interesting because it's, oh yeah, we're also lower than JXL test 100. So JXL 75 is the only one here that gets lower than JXL 100. Which is interesting because like JXL 90 was still larger than JXL 100, which I don't know if that's a thing specific to this thumbnail or what, but it's certainly interesting, right? But yeah, you can see some pretty obvious compression artifacts. Nothing too bad at all. Like if I saw a meme or an image online and it was compressed to this quality, I wouldn't even notice. But you know, for something that, you know, demands as much detail, it's a pretty obvious thing. It's really interesting. And around the orange for sure, right? Oh yeah. We're getting some really interesting like stripes here in the orange. Do they go the other way on the horizontal line? Yeah, just about, huh? Okay. Yeah, so now I'm gonna go back to the original version. And now we're gonna go to 50. Still can't tell, which is great, but when we zoom in, oh yeah, there's even less resolution compared to 75. Yeah, so this is 75, this is 50, for sure. I'm noticing some pretty obvious, like, squares here. Do you see those? There's, like, squares that the image is split into, which I find interesting. There's sort of a weird glowing effect around the corner of this cross. I feel like a lot of the stripes are gone. Yeah, there used to be a stripe here, but there's not a stripe anymore, which is interesting. And then comparing this to the lossless version, you know, you see a lot more resolution in the background at 50. The PNG level as opposed to 50 on JXL. Just broadly, you know, all the dots kind of glow, or they have this, like, weird, noisy background. And, you know, it's certainly interesting. How's the text look? Oh, yeah, for sure. Okay, cool. Let's go to 50 now. Oh, no, we're going to 10, sorry. Yes, this is 10. Original 10. So a pretty obvious difference now. Something seems way different. I don't know exactly what. Zooming in, you can tell even less. It seems like there's sort of a blue. Do you see that? Yeah. I don't know if you guys are seeing this, but there's sort of a bluish sort of square pattern, and I don't think that's from the. There's sort of a bluish square pattern. It looks like a lot of the dots have lost a lot of their definition. There's barely any definition in the background at 10, right? And you could just see that. I don't even have to point anything out in particular. Yeah. Orange line is way less resolution for crops. How are we? We kind of have some glowing stuff on the edges. Is that the same areas as 50? It looks like the glowing edge sort of ended here, but now they're both coming out of these ends, which is interesting. That noise effect around the dots is even more pronounced, so you can see it here. But it looks like it's mostly disappearing in favor of this weird, like, bluish haze that kind of goes over everything. I don't know exactly what that is. Here's the original version. Original 10. Now, let's look at the original version, and let's go to 1. 1 quality. And everything just sort of seems dimmer, frankly. These dots are way more bright on the normal version, but let's zoom in. And it looks like everything is sort of a almost spherical dot, which is interesting when compared to this. It looks like there's definitely, you can tell that there was something happening back here. You know, it's not just a solid color, but you don't see any of the sort of sand, like, wavy pattern that you get here. You just sort of get vague concepts, which is interesting. And here you just get just dots. Some of them have, like, black rings around them, which is interesting. I don't know what that is. The glowing thing looks like you don't have the glowing thing anymore, but it does kind of get darker near the edges, which is interesting. It looks like there's sort of a solid stripe going through the middle of this line here. Do you see that? It looks like the shape of some of these dots changes. It looks like they're either, like, going toward each other or away from each other, which is interesting. It gets, like, kind of blurry in some areas, like, more blurry than usual. Okay. And now let's go from 1. So let's go from normal to 1 quality with 1 effort, as opposed to 1 quality with 10 effort. So this, which going between 1 and 1 1 with 10 effort and 1 with 1 effort, it looks like there is some difference. And frankly, this is 1 with 1 effort and this is 1 with 10 effort. This is 1 with 1 effort and then this is 1 with 10 effort. Which is interesting because I think maybe the 1 with 1 effort might look a little better. But let's zoom in and take a look. Huh. Maybe it's the noise messing it up in the background, but I've noticed that on one quality with 10 effort, there's like these dots. There's like these dots in between all of the other dots, but here there's just none. It's just dots on the by themselves. Hold on. Yeah. Higher numbers allow for more computation at the expense of time. So it's interesting that in this specific scenario, it looks like one quality with one effort looks a little better. But you know, maybe that's just specific to this thumbnail. Oh yeah, looking at the cross, it's pretty obvious it's worse. You can tell there's like weird, like it looks like it's like skin, like muscle or something. And it's a lot darker near the edges, I believe. Yeah, look at that. And in the background, I feel like there's a similar amount of quality, but it's a lot blockier. Like there's less blurriness, you know? And then of course this is compared to the original, which looks like this. Yeah, just looking around. It looks like with one effort, there's some pretty obvious squares of like higher detail. So this is one with one effort, and then this is one with 10 effort. So you can tell that like things are definitely done more sloppy, you know. Yeah, you can really tell. All right, here's the text for sure. Well, yeah, so do keep in mind that 100, it's half the size for literally the exact same resolution, but you know, when you get down to 1, of course it looks a lot worse, right? So I think it gets darker because there's less surface area that's taken up by the dots, because it's kind of blurry here. It's only at max brightness in the inner 4 squares. But yeah, I'm gonna study in just a moment. I'm gonna pause my video really quick so I can check my phone before I turn it off and study. Hey everyone. I was thinking RAID 1, but I went for RAID 5 because it mentioned three disks, which is the minimum for RAID 5, but it did say mirrored data protection, so it makes sense that they went for one. I accidentally pressed that one. This question is formatted really weirdly. It's like a fill in the blank thing. Maybe they added this yesterday or today because I didn't see this yesterday. It's asking like what is here. Weird. I know we should reformat a hard drive. Thank you. I'm gonna say USB-C, but this might be an old question, and it may be USB-B. Okay, cool. It's not an old question. I was thinking maybe it was a driver thing, but then I remembered that that was the stupidest question in the world, and it thinks that color settings and like resolution have something to do with each other, which they may have in the past, but never in my life have I ever had weird colors on a monitor, and it's because the resolution is wrong. Like, what are you talking about? I'm gonna check something really quick. It'll just be maybe 5 minutes. Thank you. I didn't know it said reduce. I accidentally pressed that one. I thought this said dual layer double-sided Blu-ray, not DVD. I need to use the restroom really quick. Time to log in. Beep boop, beep beep boop. Locking in. I feel like this one is partly true. For some reason, clicking on this brings you to the next one for some reason, but so I'm not going to do that to highlight it, but this is part. I the reason why I thought this was true is because it says close the pop-up window and ignore the warning, and that's true. If you get a pop-up saying that you have a virus, that's not a pop-up, can't diagnose that, you know. It's probably just trying to scam you. It's a false virus warning. So while this is true, if you do get a pop-up like that, you probably are doing things on your computer that would result in you getting a virus. So maybe you should run a full system scan and update virus definitions. But I was thinking, you know, you should just ignore the warning, but maybe you should also update virus definitions. But, you know, turns out I was wrong. I get that. So, yeah, that was my reasoning for picking three instead of one. I thought I was talking about it and wanting to install a 32-bit application, not wanting to install a 32-bit processor. I press it accidentally. Just one sec. Hey, everyone. I feel like those answers are synonymous, but you know. Sorry, but this is also the case with Blu-ray disc. I don't know why they're like, oh, only Blu-ray recordables have a blue laser light. They both have blue laser light, and they both allow data to be packed more tightly onto the disc. That's stupid. For the record, it was also wrong, but I meant to press sheep dip computer, not safe mode. I know that active heat sinks are used to cool high-end video cards, but I remember a question formatted like this, where you wouldn't expect the answer to be liquid cooling, but it is. But I don't remember what it was. I thought it was maybe this one, but it's not. And I know that active heat sinks are used on GPUs. Okay, I'm gonna go through the ones that it's not sure of, unless it's like a gigantic amount, which I don't think it will be. Still learning is 974. It's over. Which ones am I for sure on? Who made this? Is this like an AI thing? Weird. I think I'll pretty consistently get a lot of these correct. Okay, I don't know. Aside from that one I got wrong, this seems pretty good. I'm gonna do a quiz, and see how much I get correct. Multiple choice, 85. How about 90? Okay, let's see. I definitely passed, but I don't. Okay, 94. That's great. That's great.
Cool.
Nice. Great. Great. Okay. I see. Okay, cool. Nice. That was pretty good. Good. Okay, well, I'm gonna do some emails now. Bye.